फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर मोनालिजा, नाउ अगेन विद द डिटेल्स ऑफ नीट पीजी एनाटॉमी एमसीक्यू पार्ट 8. सो दिस इज इन कंटिन्यूएशन. सो टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग द पार्ट 8 ऑफ नीट पीजी एनाटॉमी एमसीक्यूज. माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर मोनालिजा, आई हैव डन माई एमडी एनाटॉमी फ्रॉम आर्म फोर्स मेडिकल कॉलेज पुणे एंड आई एम योर फैकल्टी फॉर द एनाटॉमी सब्जेक्ट ऑन द अनअकैडमी नीट पीजी प्लेटफॉर्म. सो यू कैन यूज माई कोड, दैट इज Dr. Liza Das YT, for 10% discount availing on the NEET PG platform of Unacademy. Also, you can join the Telegram link of Unacademy platform for the NEET PG and for the NEET PG course, in which various 19 subjects teachers are there, their faculties and educators, and they are all the details of their upcoming free live session is there. So please do join this Telegram group link of Unacademy platform. It will be very beneficial for all the NEET PG aspirants. Now coming with the discussion of MCQ. So starting with the first MCQ, musculopharynx artery give rise to which of the following? Anterior intercostal arteries for intercostal space 7 to 9th. Posterior intercostal arteries for intercostal space 3 to 11, subcostal artery and inferior phrenic artery. Now, coming to the description of these MCQ, just see here. What we can see here that this is the internal thoracic artery, internal thoracic artery. Now, internal thoracic artery, which is a branch of subclavian artery, the two terminal branches of it is, one is superior epigastric, another is musculopharynx. So, what was the MCQ? The MCQ was about the musculopharynx artery. Musculopharynx artery. Okay, the MCQ was about musculopharynx artery, and it is, as you have seen, it is one of the terminal branch of internal thoracic artery, as you can see in the diagram. And one of the important branch of this musculopharynx artery is it is giving rise to anterior intercostal arteries. Anterior intercostal artery. So you can see here 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th and 9th. Actually, anterior intercostal artery is total 9 in number. It is given only 9 intercostal space, of which 1st to 6th anterior intercostal artery is branch of internal thoracic artery. Internal thoracic artery. And if we talk about 7th, 8th and 9th anterior intercostal artery, it is a branch of musculopharynx artery. It's branch of musculopharynx artery. So this was asked in the MCQ. So what you see, musculopharynx artery give rise to which of the following artery? So the correct answer will be option A, that is anterior intercostal arteries for the intercostal space of 7, 8 and 9 is a branch of musculopharynx artery. Now posterior intercostal arteries for intercostal space 3 and 11, actually posterior intercostal arteries are the branches of thoracic aortas and subcostal and inferior phrenic arteries. So I will also give you the details of this. Firstly, posterior intercostal arteries. This is from 3rd to 11th space. These are the branches of from 3rd to 11th intercostal space, or from 3rd to 11th posterior intercostal arteries. They are the branch of descending thoracic aorta and 1st and 2nd are branch of supreme intercostal artery. Supreme intercostal artery, which is also called as superior intercostal artery, and it is a branch of costocervical trunk, and costocervical trunk is a branch of subclavian artery. So this was the other option. So we have also discussed the incorrect MCQ options. Moving to the next incorrect MCQ, that was also given about subcostal and that of inferior phrenic artery. Actually, the subcostal artery lies below the last rib. So there is only the intercostal artery is named till the 11 intercostal space. The last space is given a particular name, that is subcostal artery, and it continues as the branch derived from thoracic aorta. Inferior phrenic artery. Inferior phrenic artery is a branch which is from the front of the aorta above the celiac trunk. So it is a direct branch. Inferior phrenic artery is a direct branch of abdominal aorta. And it is the ventral branch. Actually, it is the ventral branch of abdominal aorta, which is given just above the celiac trunk branch, which is also a branch from the ventral aspect of abdominal aorta. So we have done with all the options and we have also seen the correct option. Now moving to the next MCQ. Which nerve might be damaged by fracture involving cavernous sinus? Option are olfactory tract, optic, abducens, and fascia. So let's see the relation of nerves in relation to cavernous sinus. So this is a diagram in which we can see the lateral wall of cavernous sinus is related to following nerves: oculomotor, so this is the oculomotor nerve, the trochlear nerve, this is the trochlear nerve, also the abducens is lying inside, as you can see it is lying inside. So abducens nerve is not in the lateral wall, but it is also related in the interior of the cavernous sinus. And we have got one of the branch, two more branches from the trigeminal. One is ophthalmic, this is the ophthalmic, and the maxillary. So we can say that four nerves, that is the third, fourth, and two of the fifth, that is ophthalmic and maxillary nerves, is related in the lateral wall of cavernous sinus. It is related in the lateral wall of cavernous sinus. And one is traversing inside the cavernous sinus. So two structures is traversing inside. One is internal carotid artery, as you can see, this is the red color structure which you are seeing. Inside traversing through the cavernous sinus, that is internal carotid artery. Another is the abducens nerve, that is the sixth nerve. So let's write that information. So we can say lateral wall of cavernous sinus is related to following nerves. The nerves are oculomotor nerve, third cranial nerve, trochlear nerve, that is the fourth cranial nerve, and ophthalmic division and maxillary division of fifth cranial nerve. As you can see in the diagram also, all these nerves we have seen: maxillary we have seen, ophthalmic, trochlear, and oculomotor. Now coming to the details of structures which is passing through and through the cavernous sinus. So this is the structure related in lateral wall. Now structures traversing through cavernous sinus, CS, small cavernous sinus. So the structures are two structures. One is ICA, internal carotid artery, and nerve, that is abducens nerve, that is the sixth cranial nerve. So what we have seen, that all the nerves which is giving innervation to extraocular muscle, oculomotor nerve, that is the third cranial nerve, it is supplying all the extraocular muscle except LR, that is lateral six, and SO means superior oblique. Superior oblique is supplied by SO for superior oblique, it is supplied by trochlear nerve, and abducens is supplying LR means lateral rectus muscle of the eye. So all the eye muscles is which innervation is getting from these nerves are lying in relation to cavernous sinus. So if there is any injury or cavernous sinus thrombosis, this can lead to ophthalmoplegia, internal ophthalmoplegia involving these nerves. Now coming to the correct answer of the MCQ, which nerve might be damaged by fracture involving cavernous sinus? The correct answer is abducens nerve, that is the sixth cranial nerve. So olfactory tract, it is related with the olfactory nerve, close relation with the cribriform plate. Optic nerve is the second nerve, closely related with the apex of the orbit, and facial nerve, that is 7th, 8th and 11th vessel, it is related with internal acoustic meatus. So these are not the correct option. The correct option is abducens nerve. Okay, now coming to the third MCQ, which is correctly labeled, which is correct regarding the triangle of auscultation. So which statement is correct regarding the triangle of auscultation? Options are, its border are latissimus dorsi, scapula and trapezius. It is good location to hear heart murmurs. 8th and 9th ribs or intercostal space is related here, and it is located of back trauma. It's a location because of the trauma of back. Now coming to the discussion of triangle of auscultation. So firstly, I would like to show you the triangle of auscultation. So let me just enlarge this diagram. So the triangular gap which you are seeing, let me use a color green for it. So this is the triangular gap which you are seeing, and this triangular gap is triangle of auscultation. As you can see, it is having boundaries. It is bordered by three: latissimus dorsi, trapezius muscle and the medial border of the scapula. So it is a triangular space which is bordered by trapezius, latissimus dorsi muscle and that of medial border of scapula. Medial border of scapula. So here we can see inferiorly it is bounded by latissimus dorsi, superior border. Infralaterally it is bounded by trapezius. So trapezius is bounding it infralaterally, and also it is bounded by the medial border of the scapula, which is overlapped by the rhomboides muscle. So after that, coming to the additional information of a triangle of auscultation, actually triangle of auscultation is an important area on the back where it is related with the sixth intercostal space. It is related with sixth intercostal space, and actually it is in relation with lower lobes of lung. Because of its relation with the lower lobes of the lung, this space is used for hearing breath sounds. So generally this is resonant and we can hear the breath sounds. So when there is accumulation of fluid in case of pneumothorax, hemothorax, any injury or pyothorax, that breathing sound which is resonant is not heard. So this is the clinical importance of this space, and it is not used for hearing heart murmurs or heart sound, but it is used for hearing the breath sounds, and it is very resonant. As why it is resonant? Because it is not overlapped by any muscles. So this is the detail of it. Now again moving to the MCQ, which is correct regarding the triangle of auscultation. It's bordered by latissimus dorsi, scapula and trapezius. So absolutely it is correct. As we have seen the location of triangle of auscultation, it is a good to hear heart murmurs. Wrong. 8th and 9th or 8th intercostal space, no. Its location is on the back of trauma, no. It's a normal triangular space which is lying on the back. It's not because of trauma. So this is also the wrong option. So 6th intercostal space is related to it, so that is important, not the 9th or 8th intercostal space. So we have done with this MCQ. Now again coming to important points about Unacademy, how you can follow Unacademy. You have just to download the Unacademy app. Thereafter you have to find your goal, that is NEET PG, okay, and after that you have to just follow your educators or the subject which you want to read. And you have in that how you are going to know about the live free session. This can be possible if you follow or you become the member of the Telegram group of Unacademy NEET PG platform. And I would suggest that please do get connected with the Unacademy Telegram link, so that all the updates about the coming free live sessions you can know of all 19 subjects. It would be very good for all NEET PG aspirants who want to succeed in the coming 2021 examination. You can use my code DrLisa-YT for 10% discount on the Unacademy subscription. So certain important information, how you are going to find me. You can find me on the Unacademy Plus platform where my course of NEET PG Anatomy is going on. You can also follow me on the Telegram group, and you can become the member of Facebook group, that is Dr. Mona Lisa Anatomy. My free live sessions are on every Thursday for the month of July. My 14 free live sessions, I am including 14 free live sessions of 1 hour each. This timing is same, 6 p.m. and it will be done on Thursday and every Thursday. And in July month, we have got 5 Thursdays, and also on every Saturdays, and also along with it in between on the Friday. And my YouTube sessions are on every Friday and Sunday. Follow me on the Unacademy Neet PG platform. Use my code DrLisa-YT for 10% discount, and do become the member of the Telegram group link of Neet PG Unacademy platform. So thank you for today's session. Again, we will meet with the next session of MCQ discussion on Neet PG type or pattern. So all the best. Thank you.